No, can I have a booth? Is there a booth by any chance? No, one over there. So this is Taste of 20. I'm here at the Graham Buffet Club. So never had dinner here. So we'll see how that comes out. Woo! Soup soon. Everything's warm. Hot. Oh, it's one of those busier days. So let's see how the dinner is. Let's see if the extra $10 is worth it. No wait, sorry. Extra $8 is worth it. Because the lunch is $18.99 and the dinner is $24.99. So we'll find out really quickly. Excuse me. Oh, sorry. Cool. Man, it's pretty packed. I think I'll go to the less packed section first. Looks like they got pizza. A lot of Indian food. Got some chicken and shrimp. Go crazy for my right. Oh yeah. Got broccoli.
Broccoli.
Definitely need a chopstick. Kebabs. Fire roasted pork kebabs. Barbecue chicken. You know what? Let's go crazy with some more. Dishes. Looks like we got the make your own pho station. Wait. Well, can I get one with beef, rice noodles, cilantro, bell sprouts, and onions, both type of onions, and beef broth?
Oh, you said beef, rice noodles, cilantro?
Yeah. Meatballs, onions, and bean sprouts. What's in there so far? What's in there so far? Meats. Yeah. Can I more meat? Can you add more beef? More beef. Yeah. There we go. That's it. Beef broth.
Whoa.
Okay. Cool. We'll come back in 10 minutes or 5 minutes? 5 minutes?
2 minutes, yeah.
2 minutes? 2 minutes? Alright, cool, thanks. Oh, wow. We got your make your own pasta station. Need some American food. One of these bugs. So crazy with the fried chicken, buttermilk fried chicken. It's got a wing. The drumstick. Oh, yeah. Wow, I want a turkey gravy. Mmm. Let's get some of that turkey gravy. Try out definitely the noodle soup. See how it tastes. This time I got the beef with the meatballs and the noodles. Very little noodles, but I'm very impressed with the beef noodles.
Okay.
Thank you. You know, the brisket, not as good as the meatball. Definitely over the meatballs, guys. Meatballs forever. This is the stir fried chicken. Whoa, that's not juicy. Shrimp. This is the kebab. Kind of dry. But it's very well soft. Barbecue chicken. Go here. 7 out of 10. It's pretty average. But hey, it's in the buffet. Very good. Some lime. Smash some of this in. Oh yeah. Okay. So these mussels. Oh. Very good. The mussels are very good. They don't taste too much of the ocean. Thank you. I sometimes get a lot of tilt in this muscle. So. These stir fry shrimp, very tasty. Great, seasoned very, very well. That pepper doesn't improve. So good. That's probably the best thing amongst everything. The shrimp. Then the next best thing is the mussels. Very tasty. So you know the kebab chicken, very dry. Seasoned very well, but still dry. Barbecue chicken, not seasoned very well, but still slightly juicy. The broccoli. That broccoli is crispy. The butter milk chicken. Definitely get the pho with the meatballs. Meatballs all the way. Mmm.
glass of oranges. Well, that is beautiful.
Alright, first three dishes were superb. Guess it's time to grab the next couple. There are dishes here. The taco bar. El Pastor. It looks like they got the onion on top, some pineapple, and a big juicy piece.
Hi, can I just get one of the asado tacos?
Yeah, they get two of the beef tongue and two of the al pastor. Beef tongue. Pineapple. Is it possible to get some pineapple too? Pineapple? No? No pineapple? Oh, okay. Oh, over there? Right over there, huh? Did she get a pineapple from the fruit station? Cool. Gracias. How about? Get some of these guys. Some of this. I gotta go barbaric and get some of that pineapple from home. Pineapple station. Whoa. Pineapple. Some tacos. Let's find out how this Al Pastor tacos tastes over here. Okay. It's fully loaded. And I got some lime juice too. Fully loaded Al Pastor tacos. I say these are pretty good. Thank you.
That's pretty delicious apple store taco. The fact that you can get this in a buffet. This is a beef tongue taco. Don't even bother eating the beef tongue taco or any other taco after that. This is like subpar. Even though I love the beef tongue tacos here, man, I'm gonna tell you the truth right now. This Apple Store taco puts this taco to shame. Also, don't forget to put the pineapple on it. I say, that's the best Apple Store taco I've ever had at a buffet. At a buffet. That's delicious. Man, beef tongue taco is not gonna be as good after having that Apple Store taco. If I was to rate the Apple Store taco an 8, these tacos would be like a 5. Here's the funny thing, I like these beef tongue tacos here. I usually rate these like around 7 or 6. So it was 7 or an 8. So does that make the Apple Store tacos here an 11? No. It's just that the Apple Store tacos are so good that you eat any other tacos, they're not as good. Definitely try the Apple Store tacos here.
I'm very impressed with that Apple Store taco. Definitely, hands down, the best. That beats the shrimp.
For sure.
Oh man. I think I whipped those down too fast. I gotta hit those. The American fishing. So fast. Lamb chops. nearby. Slow. Is everything more rare? More rare or medium rare? That looks medium well to me.
Check out.
Oh, cool. We'll check out. Thank you, Kita. Yes. Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. Cool. Yeah. Thank you, sir. I'm not gonna get any pasta. I'm not that big of a fan of all that carbs. But this will be my final. Definitely gonna get some dessert for sure.
Ultimate judgment time. Let's see if this prime rib is anywhere nearly as good as the one from Sam's. You see? You know what? No aju. Ooh, that's tender. Without the aju, still slightly salty. Pretty delicious. Now this is drippy than aju. That's not bad. I love how tender it is. It pretty much just melts in your mouth. That type of thing. Just cut it, slice it. Oh yeah. Get a piece of that. Good.
Thank you.
Definitely not as good as the Sam's though. But hey, that, nothing to be ashamed of, because the Sam's is a really good primer, but that's pretty good. I like that. Try some of this lamb chop. Pretty good. To say the lamb chop here is really good. Slight game taste. But man, is it, you have all the good spices on it. Take some of that mint jello. Mmm. That is surprisingly good. Mm-hmm. lemon jello is very refreshing. Okay, let's put some of that mint jello on the prime rib, see how that tastes. Nope, don't do that. Alright, the ribeye. The ribeye is cooked to a medium. That's a really good ribeye. Here's the mushroom. Fantastically surprised how good that is. That's really good. Mint sauce, prime rib with the au jus. Now that is different. The edge cut part. That tastes like beef jerky. Not that bad. It's surprisingly interesting. Have some good eating so far. Let's go to the salad station. Never been too fat. We got a kind of salad. Man, they don't even have any bowls for you to grab a salad. We'll just have to get the salad here. Potato salad. We got some coleslaw. Macaroni salad. I can get some of that. Alright, okay. We got this farro salad. Okay. Let's try some of that.
half pressed salad. Mmm. Tricolor tortellini. Egg salad. Broccoli cranberry. Mmm. You know what? Let's try some broccoli cranberry. Roasted beets. I'll try some beets. Why not? So, so. Seafood soba. I'll pass on that. Oh, boy. Now, this is the toss salad. Some of that red cabbage. Man, look at the size of these cherry tomatoes. Are these really cherry tomatoes or just regular tomatoes? I don't know. But they're humongous. They're larger than my thumb. Mmm. I guess this is where you dress it up. Got some carrots for your eyes. Red carrots. Orange carrots. Mmm. I mean, I wanted to have bacon, but at the same time, I'm like, oh man, that's gonna ruin everything. Alright, Thousand Island dressing. And then, nothing but not least, the fruit salad. Can you get me a pineapple? There you go. One pineapple. And ta-da! That's my salad dish. The salads, first and foremost. Let's get them. Let's try the coleslaw. Coleslaw.
That was not very good. Sorry guys, I'm gonna waste that. That is not very well flavored. I love coleslaw, but that's not coleslaw. That's more like slightly pickled lettuce. Mmm. Try some of this. Mmm. You know what? It's pretty good. That is some really good, nicely seasoned and delicious. Looks like a good job on the macaroni sauce. Alright. Now for this fern. Salad. I'm not sure what these things are. They're slightly salty. Texture wise, they're like little tiny crumbs. They taste like bread crumbs. Mmm. Alright, let's try it with the tomato. Mmm. That's not bad. That's pretty good actually. I'm a fan of that salad. Mmm. Okay. Now for the broccoli with cranberry. Ooh, that's salty. It's like honey mustard with cranberry and broccoli. That's surprisingly good. So far, coleslaw is awful, but all these other ones are really good. Okay. Roasted cranberry. Yeah, it's okay. Still better than that coleslaw, but the worst cranberry dish so far. Okay, now for the salad that I created myself. Delicious. They got tomato. Not bad. That's down in the middle. Definitely the best salad so far that I tried was that. The farro salad, and then with the tomato and these little kind of round things. I don't know what they are. You tell me what they are. I don't know what they are. But it's pretty good. Then comes that honey mustard broccoli with cranberry. And then comes the regular salad. Then comes that roasted cranberry. And then the coleslaw. Don't get that. Don't get the coleslaw. And the pineapple. That pineapple was delish.
Time for the dessert station. I'm gonna go. Oh. Got the strawberry and a regular cheesecake. Strawberry or regular? Let's go with the regular. What? Regular cheesecake? Caramel flan, creme brulee, Vanilla Cranberry. Cranberry. Good. Go to the extreme.
First and foremost, let's try the, you know what? Let's go with the cheesecake. Cheesecake. Your cheesecake. Hmm. Surprisingly good. Good start. I'll finish you in a bit. The creme brulee, vanilla flavored creme brulee. Mmm. Actually, that's pretty good. Mmm. Combine those together. They gon' get together. Alright. Two for two. Alright, okay. But the cheesecake is better though. Cheesecake's better than the creme brulee. Oreo mousse. Mmm. That's really good. Try some of that creme brulee, some of that Oreo mousse. It's okay. The flan. Hmm. That's way too sweet. I think they use the same. Man, it's about the same. So the creme brulee and the flan, they use the same ingredient. Wherever that is. But that caramel, that's too much. That's way too sweet. The jello. Mmm. Cherry. Mmm. Cherry and pineapple. Mmm. Okay, yeah. Jell-O's definitely the middle of the bunch. So if I have to say get a dessert, definitely get the cheesecake. Number one, cheesecake. Number two, the creme brulee. And bonus, you can buy number one and number two. Number one and number two combined is excellent. Man, that's delicious. Extra bonus. If you can combine the Oreo with the creme brulee and the cheesecake. Mmm. But yeah. This is way too sweet. Too much caramel, I think. That's too much sugar. Period. So the cheesecake, then the creme brulee, then the jello, then the Oreo mousse, and then finally the flan. Flan, I love flan, but not that sweet. Not too sweet. Oh yeah. Now that's so crazy with that cheese curd. If you haven't already, smash that like button and subscribe.
Last but not least, definitely get some ice cream. I'm gonna go for some sugar-free jelly. Didn't even see that.
But I'll definitely get some gelato.
No dishes? Yeah, a cone. It's portable. Cool. Can I get a waffle cone of the passion fruit, and is that mango?
No, that's passion fruit.
Oh, they're both passion fruit?
Yeah.
Oh. Passion fruit and strawberry. Cool. Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome.
Have one. And that, my friend, is the end. So, in my opinion, is it worth the extra $8 for dinner? You know what, if you like the lamb, and you want to try the lamb, and you want some out-the-store tacos for an extra $8, and some prime rib, that's okay. Not as good as Sam's, by the way. I'll say maybe. For me, I'm never going to do this again, because it's not that great.